Very good morning, children. In the last class, I had started chapter 6 from your supplemental reader book. That was The Making of a Scientist by Robert W. Peterson. So let's recall what we studied yesterday, and then I will continue the further lesson. So what we came to know was that Richard H. Ebright has always been interested in science. In his boyhood years, and he is one of the leading scientists who have contributed significantly to biochemistry and molecular biology. At the age of 22, he excited the scientific world with a new theory which was concerned with the working of cells. Ebright and his college roommate explained the theory in an article, and it was published in the journal named Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, and it was first of his many achievements in the field of science, and it started with his studies on butterflies. Now Ebright lived in north of Reading in Pennsylvania. He was the only child of his parents and had no companions. Soon he developed the hobby of collecting things. Particularly, he was fascinated by butterflies. So he started collecting them in kindergarten. He also collected rocks, fossils, and coins. And even he became a stargazer and an eager astronomer. Okay, now let's know what was his mother's role. Ebright's mother played a great role. Okay, and she had only recognized his curiosity at an early age, and she encouraged him a lot. She took him on trips and also bought him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, and many other equipments so that he could follow his hobbies. Ebright's mother was his friend until he started the school, going to school. She would bring home friends for him. Then she found the learning activities for him. And consequently, Ebright earned top grades in school. By the time he was in second grade, he had collected 25 species of butterflies from around the hometown. And then one day Ebright's mother gave him a book, okay, which titled The Travels of Monarch X. It described that how monarch butterflies migrate to Central America, and this book again created interest in him. The author had offered the readers to help study butterfly migrations, and the readers were asked to tag the butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick Urquhart of Toronto University, Canada. Anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart. Ebright started tagging the monarch butterflies. And what he did next? He started raising the butterflies. Okay. So the butterfly collecting season, it was around Reading, which lasts only 6 weeks in late summer. Okay. And Ebright realized that chasing the butterflies one by one, means following the butterflies to catch it, it won't enable him to catch many. So he decided to raise a flock of butterflies, and he would catch a female monarch, take her eggs and raise them in his basement, from egg to caterpillar and then to pupa, at last to adult butterfly, and then he would tag the butterfly's wings and let them go. So in this way he started doing the work of developing the butterflies in different stages. So till here I ended yesterday, children. So let's continue the further lesson. Coming to your book, eventually I began to lose interest in tagging butterflies. It's tedious and there's not much feedback, Bright said. In all the time I did it, he laughed. Only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured, and they were not more than 75 miles from where I lived. So what here Bright says further, eventually means finally. Okay, so at last he started losing interest in collecting, tagging the butterflies. Okay, why? Because he found it the tedious work. Tedious means very tiresome. Okay, he got too much tired also, and he was feeling little dull and boring also. Why? Because he was not getting much feedback. Feedback means information given by the user. Okay, so he was not getting much information about it back. So Bright said that in all the time he did it, okay, and he laughed that only the two butterflies out of those many that he had tagged were recaptured. Recaptured means they were caught again, and those butterflies also were captured from where? From the nearby his house only, which was not more than 75 miles from where he lived. Okay, so he found it little bit boring work, and now he was thinking to just give up, to stop just collecting the monarch butterflies. Okay, then in the 7th grade he got a hint of what real science is when he entered a county science fair and lost. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not get anything while everybody else had won something. Bright said his entry was slides of frog tissues which he showed under a microscope. He realized the winners had tried to do real experiments, not simply make a neat display. So what happens now when he reached to the 7th class? Okay, that time he really understood this what real science is. Okay, when he entered a county means the region's science fair. As you children also know, the science fairs are organized where you can display your experiments and all models and all. So there what he did, he also participated in the region science fair, but there he lost it. He didn't win any prize there, and after that he felt very sad. Okay, to sit there and just seeing that everybody else had won something in that fair, but he was the only one who lost it. Okay, so why? Because his entry, what he had done, he had just kept the slides. You know, in the lab you might have seen children the glass plates, okay, that are the slides. So he had just kept the frog tissues. Are the mass of cells. Okay, so he had displayed only the frog's tissues which he showed under a microscope. So just he wanted to show how the cell mass of cells looks when we see through a microscope. That was only he did in the fair. Okay, and what he realized that the winners in that fair, they had tried to do the real experiments. Okay, and not only make a neat display. Neat display means they have not just shown anything, displayed anything, but they have done the real experiments and shown there. That's why they all were winners and he was the loser. Next, already the competitive spirit that drives Richard Bright was appearing. I knew that for the next year's fair I would have to do a real experiment, he said. The subject I knew most about was the insect work I had been doing in the past several years. Now, after losing in a science fair, now the competitive spirit, okay, it started taking place in his mind. Means he was now driven by means he was now just inspired by seeing all the winners, and that also made him to just enter in the competitive world. And what he decided, he said that for the next year's fair, he also would have to do a real experiment. He won't simply display anything, but he will also bring his real experiment in front of everyone. And he was sure that the subject which he knew most, which he had hold on the subject, was the insect work. Now he will try his experiments on the insects, which he was doing in the past several years. Now, so he wrote to Dr. Urquhart for ideas, and back came a stack of suggestions for experiments. Those kept Ebright busy all through high school and led to prize projects in county and international science fairs. Now what happened? Now, when he decided that he also will bring the real experiment, then he just took suggestions from Dr. Urquhart for getting new ideas from him, and came a stack of suggestions. Stack here means he got many suggestions from Dr. Urquhart, okay, to carry on his experiments. And now Ebright was very busy all through the high school. During his high school studies, he was busy with his experiments, and also it brought him many prize in different projects, okay, not only in his region but also in the international science fairs. Also he started winning the prizes. Okay, so here we come to know, children, that how much determined and hard working Ebright was, okay, which made him really a great scientist. For his 8th grade project, Ebright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Ebright thought the disease might be carried by a beetle. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. "I didn't get any real results," he said, "but I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment. This time I won." Now what happened when Ebright reached to 8th grade, okay, 8th class project work, he tried to find the cause of a viral disease. Viral disease, you know, the illness caused by the virus. So he wanted to know how this viral disease spreads that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Due to this viral disease, what was happening? It was killing all the monarch caterpillars. Every year, thousands of monarch caterpillars were dying due to the virus. So what Ebright thought, the disease might be carried by a beetle. Beetle is also an insect. It is an insect. He thought that this disease is being carried by the beetle. Okay. So he tried raising the caterpillars in the presence of beetles. He wanted to just prove that what he thought, that maybe this virus may be spread by the beetle. So he started raising the caterpillars in presence of beetles only, and that time he didn't get any result. Okay, but when he again did the experiment on it, when he moved ahead and he showed that at least he had tried that experiment, okay, and that time again he won that. The next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarchs. The theory was that viceroys look like monarchs because monarchs don't taste good to birds. Viceroys, on the other hand, do taste good to birds. So the more they look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become a bird's dinner. Okay. So next year, what happened again in his science fair project? Okay, what was the theory that he was proving? That the viceroy butterflies, okay, they copy monarchs. This was the theory which he was testing. Okay, so the viceroy butterflies copy means they imitate monarchs. Whatever the monarchs do, monarch butterflies, the viceroy also do the same, that he wanted to prove. The theory, what was that? The viceroys, they looks like monarchs. He wanted to prove that the viceroys are just like the monarchs, because the monarchs don't taste good to birds. Because what happens, these monarchs, okay, they are not eaten by the birds, but viceroys on the other hand do taste good to birds. Okay, viceroys on the other hand, they are eaten by the birds, they taste good to birds. So the more they look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become a bird's dinner. Means here, more they will look like monarchs, if they will look like monarchs, isn't it, they won't be liked by the birds for their dinner. Why? In the beginning we came to know that the birds, they liked the viceroys more than the monarchs. So if they will look like monarchs, okay, they won't be eaten by the birds for their dinner, because they will be less liked by the birds. So you can see in the picture, children, the upper one is the viceroys and the lower one is the monarchs. Okay, Ibrahim's project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. He found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. It would eat all the monarchs it could get. Ibrahim said later research by other people showed that viceroys probably do copy the monarch. This project was placed first in the zoology division and third overall in the county science fair. See, in this picture it is shown how is the monarch butterfly at the top. Okay, the top one is the monarch butterfly, and how it is different from the viceroy butterfly at the bottom. Bottom one is the viceroy butterfly. So how they looks differ, how they differs, it is shown in that picture, which is the viceroy. Viceroy is the bottom one and the monarch one is the top one. Okay, so now what happens, Ibrahim's project was to see what he what was the project now for, whether really the birds would eat the monarchs, whether really they eat the monarch butterflies. And he found that a starling is a common bird only. Okay, the common birds which we see, it would not eat the ordinary bird food. The common bird would not eat any ordinary bird food, but what it would eat, it would eat all the monarchs it could get. See, that common bird, it has much interest in eating all the monarchs, okay, it could get for its food, but it would not take any ordinary food. And Ibrahim said later research by other people showed that viceroys probably do copy the monarch. And in the research it was found that it is true that the viceroys, they imitate, they copy the monarch butterflies. Okay, and this project which he proved here, that really the monarchs are eaten by the common birds and viceroys also copies the monarchs, this project was placed first in the zoology division. Okay, zoology is also a branch, like biology is a branch of studies like zoology, where the studies of animals and all takes place. So this project was placed first position there in zoology division, and it ranked overall third in the county science fair. County means in that region, science fair, this project got the third place. Okay, in his second year in high school, Richard Ebright began the research that led to his discovery of an unknown insect hormone. Indirectly, it also led to his new theory on the life of cells. Now, when Ebright reached to the second year in the high school, okay, that time he began the research about what, that led to his discovery of an unknown insect hormone. Now he was discovering about an unknown insect hormone, means about and about the hormone of an insect. He had to research about the hormones of an insect. That also the unknown insect. Indirectly, it also led to his new theory on the life of cells. Okay, and it was the new theory which he was going to carry on the life of cells. The question he tried to answer was simple. What is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa? Now, what was the question on which he was working? What he was trying to find out through his research? One simple question's answer he was trying to get. That, what is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa? You can, that pupa, okay, after which an adult butterfly just takes place. So, he wanted to know that why that 12 tiny means very small marks, spots are the marks, are there present on the monarch's pupa. What is the purpose of that? Why it is there? Why are that 12 marks on the monarch pupa seen? Everyone assumed the spots were just ornamental, a bright said. But Dr. Urquhart didn't believe it. So everyone just assumed, means thought. What everyone thought? The just spots were only for showy purpose. Ornamental means just, it is a showy thing. It doesn't matter there, okay? A bright said, but Dr. Urquhart, he never believed it, that it is only for the showy purpose. It is just an ornamental. No. According to him, it was there for some or the other reason. To find the answer, a bright and another excellent science student first had to build a device that showed that the spots were producing a hormone necessary for the butterfly's full development. So, now they have to find the answer. Okay. So, a bright and another one very intelligent science student was there. They had to build one device, one instrument they had to build, and it showed that the spots, that the marks which were present on the monarch pupa, they were producing one hormone. Okay, they were not simply for showy purpose, but they produces the hormone which is very necessary for the full development of a butterfly. That's why those spots were there on the butterfly. Okay, that is also pupa one. So this project won a bright first place in the county fair and entry into the International Science and Engineering Fair. There he won third place for zoology. He also got a chance to work during the summer at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So this project where he found that spots were producing the hormones which are necessary for the butterfly's full development. This project won the first prize in that county fair, again in the science fair where he just brought his new research, and it brought him an entry into the International Science and Engineering Fair now. And there he won the third place for zoology. Okay, there again he got third place, and he even got the chance to work during the summer at the entomology laboratory. What is this entomology? This is relating to the insects, the science relating to insects. Okay, so he got the chance to work there during the summer of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research, one of the most reputed laboratory there. Okay, gave him chance to work there during the summer and to do his research work, which was the laboratory Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So let's stop here, children. The further I will carry in the next class. Till then, goodbye.